here by taking a new video on coordination in plants. This is a topic from class 10th science biology. So in this topic we will study what kind of system plants have for the coordination. So you all know that the plants do not have any nervous system, muscles or cells, organs like the animals, but they respond and react to various environmental stimuli such as light, water, gravity, touch, chemicals, etc. Means they also give response to some environmental factors. So they have the means by which they give response. So this means is of two types, and one type of movement is that which is independent of growth, means in which the growth is not involved, and the other type of movement is there which is dependent on growth, means the growth will occur. So the plants give response in two ways, means in the types of movements. So movements is of two types. So we will study what two type of movements are there. So they are named as tropic movements and the nestic movements. So tropic movements are those which are directional movements. Directional means either it will show the movement towards the stimuli or in opposite of the direction of the stimuli. And as growth is involved over there, so they are very slow. And slow means they will take time to give the response. And in contrast to this, there is nestic movements, and they are non-directional, means the direction of stimuli does not matter, and the movements may be slow or fast, and here the growth is not involved. So most of them are fast, so they show immediate response. So first of all, we will study the tropic movements. So tropic movements are those type of movements which occur in the direction of stimulus or away from it. So such a movement is called as the tropism. And the plants, already I told you that they respond to light, touch, gravity and other kind of stimulus. So the tropism is also of four types: phototropism, chemotropism, hydrotropism and the geotropism. So all we will study one by. So first one is phototropism. Photo means light. So we can derive the meaning from the term only. So it means it is the plant will give response to the light. For example, the stem of the plant, it grows towards light. If in the diagram or in the picture you can see, if the plant is getting the light from all direction, then it is growing straight. But if the plant is getting and it is kept in the dark room and it is getting light from the one side, so stem will show the bending towards the source of light. So this is the phototropism. And geotropism, geo means gravity, means the response of plant part towards the gravity is called as the geotropism. So we have the example as the movement of plant roots, that the roots grow towards the gravity. So this is an experiment as well, which is shown in the picture. If we keep the potted plant horizontal, then after a few days we will see that the stem, it will start growing towards the light, that is upward, whereas the roots, they will start growing towards the gravity. So this diagram is showing both the things, phototropism as well as the geotropism. So this is an experiment. We have an experiment to show or to demonstrate the hydrotropism. See this experiment. This is written in the previous slide. So what is there? There are two troughs and both the troughs are filled with the soil. Soil is there. And in one of the trough, in the trough B, there we insert a potted clay pot, because clay pot is porous. So that's why we prefer this one. So we just insert it into the soil and fill it with the water. Whereas in the trough A, no such kind of arrangement is done. And simply what we have to do, we have to water the plant which is growing in the trough A, and we have not to provide any water to the trough B because already water is there in the clay pot. So after few days we will see in the trough A there is a uniform pattern of the root growth, whereas in the trough B the roots show the growth towards the clay pot because clay pot is porous, so the water seeps into the soil. So that's why. So this is the experiment which is demonstrating the hydrotropism. So this is the another type of movement by which the plant give response, that is nestic movements. So already I told you ki these are non-directional movements, and these occur due to the change in the turgor pressure or turgor changes, means osmosis. It is related to the osmosis, or you can say it is due to the change in the amount of water. If you are not able to understand the word turgor, means change in the amount of water. This because of that these are caused. So they show immediate response to the stimulus, but there is no such kind of growth, and they are induced by light, temperature or the touch. We have the example of touch stimulus. That is there is a plant, touch me not plant, mimosa pudica plant, and if we touch that plant, its leaves gets fold and droop. So this is the example of the nastic movement. So this is the mimosa pudica plant, which is in the first pic. In the A you can see their normal leaves, and after touching these leaves, what happens? They droop and gets fold. This happens in the nastic movement. So we have the example of touch me not plant.